Good morning, students. In today's class, we will go with conversation part 2. Why part 2? Because in my previous video, I have just finished lesson number 1 at home. In the beginning of that part 1, I told you there is 4 parts in this lesson. 2 I have finished in part 1, and in this video, we will go with the next 2. Topic or the explanation. Okay, the first one is a guest at home. Children, just take out your conversation book, page number 7. The first topic of today is a guest at home. Okay. Now here, two characters has been mentioned here. The one is Mala. The second one is Mr. Raman. Two characters, okay. First one is Mala is there, and the second one is Mr. Who is that? Mr. Raman is there. Okay. Now here the conversation between Mala and Mr. Raman. So here, what do you mean a guest at home, children? Suppose someone is coming at your home and your parents are not there at that particular time. You will not bang the door and tell them, go in here. You will just tell them to be come inside, make them sit, and then you talk, and then you will be saying that my father or mother is not here at that particular time. Okay, now I begin. So here is the conversation between Mala and Raman. Mr. Raman saying how Mala is giving a respect, welcoming that Mr. Raman, a guest to her home. The first one is Mala. Good evening, uncle. Please come in. Mr. Raman. Good evening. Is daddy at home? Mala. Yes, uncle. He is having a bath. Please be seated. Mr. Raman. Thank you. Which class are you in, dear? So here in this particular paragraph, I can say is that Mala is wishing Mr. Raman and telling her to please come inside the house. And again, Mr. Raman is saying that good evening, and he is asking a question. What question, children? Is daddy at home? So Mala is asking, yes, he is there, but what is daddy? Her daddy is doing? Her daddy is taking a bath. And for that reason, Mala is welcoming Mr. Raman, a guest, to her home and making him seated there inside. Now, again, what is the question Mr. Raman is asking? That which class are you in, dear? That means that the moment of time, Mala and Mr. Raman is only there. So Mr. Raman is asking a question to Mala that in which class are you? And what is the answer? Mala is saying, I am in class 5. Mr. Raman, and which school do you go? Sorry, in which school do you go to? Mala is answering, which school? To Arrow Public School. Mr. Raman is saying, good, Mala. I think daddy has had his bath. I will call him. So there's a conversation between Mala and Mr. Raman, and they both are, and Mr. Raman is asking Mala, in which class are you? In which school are you? And in the time being, Mala is telling that I think the daddy has taken a bath and he will be coming. That means this Mala, the child Mala, is paying a respect, giving hospitality. Hospitality means if someone is coming to your home, you just welcome that person, make him sit, offer water. See, all this is known as an hospitality. So here, the guest at home, and two characters are Mala and Mr. Raman. Now children, just turn your page to page number 8. Now, hope you have just turned to page number 8. Here, the topic is for children between father and son. So here, it's a topic is between, who is there children? Between father and son. So here there is a conversation between a father and a son. The two characters are mentioned. What are they? The two characters, the father is there, and the second son is saying, "Daddy, here's my progress card." Progress card means report card. So, see, looking at the picture, and the son is saying, "Daddy, here's my progress card." Progress card means a report card. So, father is saying, "You have scored very less in maths and science. In which subject?" Father is asking, just telling the son that you have scored very less. Scored means you got very less marks in maths and science. The son is saying, everyone in the class has got less marks. See, the same dialogues, na? See, if you are giving some tests and you have got very less marks, what you say when your father or mother asks, why you have got less marks? So what is your response, children? That, sabko kam marks mila. The same way, the son is saying, everyone in the class has got less marks. The father is saying, I don't want to know about the others. Tell me your problem. The father is asked, just telling that, I don't want to know that who got what marks. But you just tell me, what is your problem? Why did you got so less marks in maths and science? The son is saying, the teachers don't explain things well. See, again, the same thing, na, some of the children might, when they get less marks, what you do? You blame it on the teachers and tell them, teachers doesn't explain things well. So what is the father's response? See, father is not appreciating this answer of the child. The father is telling, I am not asking you about your teachers. Tell me your problem. See, the parents, if they support like this, the children, that teachers are not teaching well. But here, what the father is telling children, the father is telling that I don't want to ask about the teacher, I want to know what is your problem. So here the son is telling, I think I did not prepare well for the test. Now the son is confessing. Confessing means he's accepting his mistake and telling that I think I have not prepared very well for the test, so I got less marks. Father is telling, that's it. Son, I will do well next time, daddy. Father, and I will help you with the lessons from tomorrow. So now father and son is having a good communication here. See, the son is accepting his mistake, that it was not the mistake of the teacher. It was his mistake that he has not prepared well for the test, and for that reason he got very less marks in maths and science. Father is also telling, okay, good, that thing is that you accepted the mistake, and the father is also telling that from tomorrow he will be also helping the child to learn his lesson. And what is the response of the son there? Son is saying, thank you, daddy. So hope children have understood both the topic. So just kindly go through it by video once again and read the chapter. Thank you.